panceta de...
Arrosto di manzo.
Mine is arrosto di manzo.
Di manzo.
Oh, okay.
And your choice, panceta a la gringo.
Panceta a la gringo.
Maybe pork belly.
Thank you, Kuya Fernan. Thank you, Kuya Fernan. Happy Valentine's, Kuya. Try your signature lemonade. You will love it, baby.
Good. Delicious.
Right? It's great. Did you see that? Did you go out? You went to the farm? We got those from the farm. And you're drinking farm fresh veggies and herbs.
Top salad po with balsamic and then calamari po.
This is not our order though.
And then you first the gourmet pizza.
Oh yes!
The famous pizza.
Oh my, is that for you, Em?
Wow.
So we're celebrating here at the Gourmet Farms and I am with my darling friends, MJ and Ron Bolivar. And we are with their baby, Ayola. Okay? And Ayola is three years old rather. Ayola. Ron is on. Say hi, there's Ayola. She's having fun because the space is really huge. And so we're gonna have a snack and then later I will interview them. Ooh, we're gonna talk about relationships.
Oh my god.
So Ron and MJ are scared at this point. They're worried because I might ask them questions that are tricky to answer. Okay, I hope you guys are.
Kung di pa sa yung kapo na.
Oh, wow!
Okay.
We are eating at the Gourmet Farms and this is the panceta de grillo. Luscious pork belly. This is the most delicious curry. This is our famous signature limonada. It's so refreshing. Super duper young.
She's singing.
Ayola is singing with the birds. She's loving this. And now for our pizza. So here's a little pasta. No, it's actually a very huge pasta. Did I say little? No. It's not little. It's a really huge plate of pasta. No, this is my favorite. My full pasta. I can still see the smoke coming up. This is really one. I'm gonna make you guys try it. This is truffle pasta. This is what I'm talking about. Look at that. And so my brother means business when he talks about the truffle pasta, which is my favorite. One of my favorite pastas ever. Why am I so red in the photo? I'm turning red because I'm so embarrassed because I'm almost did not make it on time. Almost, I said one to two because we were rerouted. Don't pass, don't ever. Okay, right now I'm gonna tell you, do not pass Maguyam. It is wrong. Don't ever exit Cremona. Do not ever exit southwards. Don't exit southwards right now. The shortcut isn't short. The shortcut lately, it's the very longest route ever right now. it's supposed to be the shortcut. It's the fastest way here, but they are, I don't know, they are diverting. They will reroute you, and it's not traceable via Waze because they've set up this new garden area in the Iba area. People, it's a new place. It's a new place where they sell plants. So now, you know how everyone's selling plants these days? Don't go there because they had just established that Iba detour. It's like a plant world, plant city. So no, it's not a good idea to pass Maguya. Ron, what are you eating?
Like a pork belly with like sour side dish. It's really nice. It's nice here. It's my first time here in Gourmet Farm.
So how are you enjoying?
Yeah, it's nice. Kids can play around for now. they have a section where kids can play. So.
Yeah, because Ayola is here.
Yeah.
Yeah, look at her. She's nagging. You have to join her, she says. So, MJ, what are you eating?
Roast beef. I don't know. I forgot exactly what you call this, but it's a roast beef, and it's really good. Tender and yummy.
Does it come with a side dish? I don't know.
With mashed potatoes.
It has mashed potatoes.
Yes.
Ooh. Mm. Yes.
Try this,
I will. I'm a beef eater. Nice.
Yeah, let's eat.
Nice.
Oh, hi. Yola. Hi.
So there's MJ. I am going to ask her about some relationship questions.
Oh my.
And Ron is just in the toilet. So we're just going to ask Ron and MJ some love or relationship questions, and I want to know if they're going to be able to answer those questions. So, MJ, are you ready?
Wait, ready or not? Is there a pass?
Is there a choice? There's no pass button.
Oh my god.
You have to answer all my questions.
I'll do my best.
I know you will. Okay, so we're just waiting for Ron, but we are going to transfer. Because there are a lot of mosquitoes. Thank God MJ brought this. Yes! Because we are being smothered by insects! So we are being smothered by insects because, of course, we are in the forest. We love eating in the forest, don't we? I mean, this is fun. This is fun, but there are things that will bite you at the same time. That's expected. Have you been bitten?
So
by an
far, nothing itchy.
Nothing itchy so far?
Yes.
What is that? Effective. Is that a mole? Do you have moles?
Mine is.
If you have a mole, I know that when you have a mole in your foot, it means you like to go out. And I have.
You have?
I have a mole in my foot. Like, listen to the music.
I love the sound.
I love the music. I think they're gonna have a band here later. And just for you guys to have an idea of how romantic it's gonna be later on, I will show you how it looks like because they've started to set up for the dinner. And MJ, Ron, and I will move to the enclosed resto for our interview.
Oh my god.
Nice, Ola.
Wow, fresh.
Freshly picked.
Your
you make your own salad. Nice, right?
Yeah.
They call this a salad bar, and then they weigh it. The band is there. Yeah.
That's ube. You want ube? The chocolate, dark chocolate.
Oh, like what she wanted to eat? Okay, listen up, lovebirds. I have a question for you folks. How long have you been married?
3 years. 9 years. It's coming April
8th. Ew.
No, I 9 years.
Ew. 9 years abroad? Ew. Okay. Now, any of you can answer this question. Why does a woman need to be married for her to believe that a man loves her? I guess MJ can answer that question first. I mean, if Ron didn't marry you, would you believe that he still loves you?
Maybe he loves me, but
there's a but.
Maybe he's afraid of
committing to you.
Afraid of commitment.
And so, if he doesn't, okay. So, if he's afraid of commitment, what does that imply? So, what if he's afraid of commitment? What does that tell you as a woman?
Maybe he's not that brave to face responsibilities, because being married and becoming a husband, it's not just simply loving the woman romantically or making her happy, but there's a lot of things.
Like a financial
building a
commitment,
building a home, building a family, and of course, yes, financially. He must be really responsible.
He has to take care, the woman. Gotcha. Very good. Okay, for Ron, do you believe that a man, let's say you, okay, you don't marry a woman, the woman that you say you love, would you be able to say that you truly love the woman?
Oh, my brother. Hi, come here.
Come. So... Okay, so Ron, would you say that you really love, you can really love a woman without marrying her? I guess that's the bottom line.
But maybe because we're Filipino, we have this thinking that if you're in a relationship, the next level would be marriage. So it's like you're like wanting to point out that you are ready to commit to the next level of your relationship.
Yeah, but Ron, but what if you know in your heart you love the person, but if, let's say, you just don't believe in marriage, does that mean you don't love the person anymore? Excuse me, does that mean you don't love the person anymore?
Well, for me, I respect those people who don't commit to marriage. But our generation, like, we really believe in marriage.
Oh, yeah?
I really cannot, like, explain those people or those couple that...
Been together for the longest time, yeah,
but
they I've never been married.
Yes.
Gotcha. Okay, so in short, you won't believe a guy could love a woman if he eventually doesn't marry her.
Yes, that's what. Okay. There's a line in a certain movie that I watched before. It says, "Love the woman you marry, but not necessarily marry the woman you love."
Oh.
Wow.
Nice. Beautiful.
And mother talk.
Wow. What is it?
Mother chocolate.
Thank you. Wow, that's beautiful.
Ayola.
Ayola. Look at what's here, baby.
Come here, baby. Yeah.
Hi, panna cotta. Oh, okay.
Polvorones now.
Polvorones. Kuya, hello. Happy Valentine's to the staff of Gourmet Farms. Yeah. You'll be in the vlog, Kuya.
You get the teaspoon, man.
Love it. Well, look at this. Check this out. This is the panna cotta. Very, very delicious. I am a lover of panna cotta. It's getting dark. It's around what time? What time is it?
Five.
It's already five. Looks like we're gonna be here in Tokyo. Good, right? I wanted to try this too. So I'm gonna try the polvorones for the very first time because my brother highly recommends the polvorones gelato. Let's see. Oh yeah, we're fans of Naruto. There. We are fans of Naruto. Have you eaten dessert? You guys eaten dessert? What did you guys eat? Go ahead and eat that. Polvorones gelato. Oh, Ron. How often did you guys go out on dates before you got married?
were the things that changed after marriage?
I really can't recall anymore if we're going out on dates during weekends. But I think we at least once a week.
Did you go out at least once a week?
Yeah, once a week. But okay. There's no certain day.
Once a week
at least.
Then after marriage and when we have kids, we seldom go out without them.
Without the
kids. Did you guys have a first love before you met each other?
Yes.
Yeah, oh, big yes. Bringing back the memories. Okay.
Before Ron's relationship.
But that wasn't real love.
It was real love.
A quick relationship, but it was...
Yeah, because he's a Korean.
Yeah.
He had to go back to Korea to serve military.
Oh,
that's
wow. He was conscripted.
That's why we ended the relationship before he left. And he said that in Korea, if you will ask a girl to wait for you after military, you're like an asshole. Because in two year time, there could be a lot of things that could happen.
It's true.
So you just let the girl live how she wants to live while you're apart. When he comes back and if you still love each other, then maybe. But if not, then it's okay. At least you did not leave the girl staying committed to you.
Thank you. Good answer. I didn't know that. What about you, Ron?
In the relationship for 5 years before.
Oh my God, no. Were you?
Yes. It's like a college sweetheart.
Oh!
Then after graduation.
Why did you guys break up?
Maybe because we outgrew each other.
You outgrew each other.
Yes.
And I guess you guys like different things.
When I started to work, I met some new set of friends. And I go out sometimes alone without her. So I don't know that if that's one of the reasons why.
She got mad at you too?
I don't know if she got mad.
Are you allowed to have crushes?
Yes.
Okay. Who's your biggest crush? Of course, apart from MJ.
Ivana Alawi. Maybe. I don't know.
What about you, MJ? Oh my gosh, Yunbin.
I do have a big crush on Gary V.
Gary Valenciano? Wow. Nice.
When I saw him one time before when I was in high school, I was starstruck. And I never...
You never outgrew.
Forget about him since that day.
So,
what flavor is that? And what the chocolate is?
There's my brother. Who's in charge of the budget in the house?
It's Ron.
Really?
Yeah. It's Ron.
What? Ron
is very good.
With money?
He's very good with money. He is very organized. He has logbook or blue book. Yeah.
No.
He writes everything.
Okay, what if you like something? Let's say you like something that's not necessary. Do you have to have a consensus before you purchase something?
Yeah.
Oh, you have to.
I at least tell him. If it's not really something that I need, I will ask him first. Is it okay if I get this? Because we don't need it, right? But if it's something that's needed in the house, I'll just tell him that I got this already or I ordered something.
Like the guitar. I saw the guitar.
The guitar. Oh, that's my money, so it's okay.
Oh, you guys keep separate money.
The only money that I can say that is my own money and I can spend it however I want to is the 13-month pay.
Oh, but everything else goes one account.
In one account, and he has to manage everything.
Nice.
So I have to ask him if I want something.
What happens if you manage the money, MJ? What's wrong with you managing the money?
I don't think...
You will spend.
No, I'm not like that. I can also manage it. But he is better because I can also do it really well.
Oh,
yes. Okay. Just that I have so much in my hands already. I do everything in the house. So I do all the household chores.
Okay.
I take care of the baby and everything.
Okay. Got it. Thank you. Oh, what do you miss most about being single? Uh-huh. Be honest, MJ.
Like not sharing a toilet.
Or you've forgotten what it's like to be single.
Actually.
Right? Right? Yeah. So you don't know what you're missing anymore.
Yeah, maybe because I feel content right now, maybe. That's why I can't think of anything that I miss from the past,
right,
from being single.
Exactly.
Because I'm just loving everything.
About being marriage.
Married, about being a mother.
Oh my god, that's great. That is
maybe that's
great.
Right.
That is so great. Thank you, MJ! Good job. So that's it. Those are some of the questions I asked a lovely couple. Unfortunately, Ron couldn't join us anymore because we had to step outside with Ayola. But we had a good time here at Gourmet Farms. And we are about to back up because it's already getting late. It's almost dinner time. But we did
from
arrive
lunch to dinner.
From lunch to dinner. But we did arrive quite late, actually. So I hope you enjoyed listening to MJ and Ron sharing us their point of views in relationships. So there you go, maybe on the next day, because I still have a whole bunch of questions that need to be answered. Have a lot. But this time it's more of a game, like getting, like, how well do you know your partner? Like, I have some questions that will tell you, gauge how well do you know your partner, even if you've been together for like 10 years. You might be surprised that, you know, you don't really know every single thing about your partner until a little activity. So we'll see you again on the next time.
Look, thanks for
yes, and I'm happy that Ayola's here. You know, she's free to do things. Run. Diba? MJ and Ron and Ayola.
Hello,
say hi, Ayola.
Hi.
Baby. That's my mom, you know.
I'm the Lola.
That's my mom. That's my tita. And that's my brother.
I'm the Lola.
Happy birthday, Fiones! Woo! So my family and I are ready to go home, and it's getting late unless we're gonna have dinner here. So if you have time to go to the Gourmet Farm, look at how beautiful this place is. It's filled with plants, gardens. Everything beautiful is here at the Gourmet Farms, including the delicious food. So hurry up if you haven't been here, or if you have.
Girl, happy Valentine!
Happy Valentine!
So if you haven't had a chance to come to the Gourmet Farms, if you want to come over during Valentine's, you can do it next year, because this year is going to be too late. And they have this beautiful, beautiful setup. I just decided that we were. I decided we were gonna do, we were gonna have it over lunch. The place is just so beautiful. The ambiance is perfect for lovebirds. I will show you what I mean. There's a lovely band that's playing.